are you this beautiful day? Isn't this a beautiful morning?
Very!
Hasty post, how's this?
That's an awfully elegant pose, but is all that elegance necessary?
And why not? I represent Maritech, don't I? We're not a butcher shop or a hardware store. We're a perfumery. That means we're
stylish.
That's it.
With a quiet dignity.
Yes, and we get the tilt of our hats right.
That's right.
When I ride my bike, you can see what Maritech's like. So I think it's very important that I look my best.
And how many people did you run over today?
Not one.
Well, it's early.
Here comes Miss Ritter. She spent the night with Mr. Red-Eye.
Again?
They always kiss goodbye at the newsstand. Then she walks around the block to make us think she's been home.
Good morning.
Good day.
How are you this glorious day? Have you seen a lovelier morning?
Never.
It's too nice a day to be inside shuffling soap. I have no more energy whatsoever. Anybody mind if I take the day off? Arpad, why aren't you old enough to take me away from all this?
I'm old enough.
Well, then marry me, and I'll quit my job. No, I'm afraid you're really not quite old enough.
It won't be long, though. I'm catching up. Ms. Horvath always used to say, I get to be 35 before you ever did.
Good morning.
Good day.
How are you this radiant day? What a rare magnificent morning.
Is it?
Good morning, my dear. How are you this ravishing day? You know you never look more exquisite.
Thank you, kind sir.
What a lovely dress.
It's the same one she had on yesterday, Mr. Kudai.
Ah, Mr. Novak.
Good morning.
Good day.
Isn't that a beautiful sky? The perfect sample of summer weather. It's too nice a day to be indoors counting out change. But a waste of holiday weather all together. Let's all run away.
Wouldn't it be something if we all took off from work?
Leaving Mr. Maritech without a single flirt.
Why not have a picnic?
I could bring my wife desserts.
Champagne might be nice with hors
d'oeuvres. It's too nice to say.
It's
stuck inside the store.
And we'd all be out of a job.
If it costs that much to get suntanned,
I'll stay untanned.
Hail the salt.
A picnic.
A picnic.
Oh, well.
Was the chicken the usual success?
Hmm?
Your weekly dinner with Mr. and Mrs. Maritech.
Oh, yes.
Did you talk to Mr. Maritech about replacing Ms. Horvath?
I mentioned it, but absolutely not. After all, business the way it's been.
Yes, but it's bound to pick up now that Hammersmith's is closed.
Have you ever tried their hand cream? I wonder if it's any good.
Good? My dear woman, my wife has been using their products for years. In fact, I often wonder why their products are so much better than everyone else's.
Well, you should know, Mr. Maritech.
Good morning, Mr. Maritech.
Good day.
Good day, madam. May I help you?
I would like to see a
face like yours
wrapped but we carry.
Do you have a cream for
cherry red?
Oh, I see what you mean.
You will look enchanting.
Dry lips.
Glamorous as Garbo.
Big mouth.
I would recommend a
bath
to take.
Conceal, did you say?
Put a little lipstick
on your nose.
Twice.
Morning and evening.
And a little brush for
calling my
teeth. Absolutely.
Wrap it up and send it. Thank you so much.
Is there something else before you?
Want to clip your
earlobe?
You may want to dye your
hangnails.
Dab a little on your
husband's face.
Won't he be surprised? Under my chin, there's an idea.
Madam, I am filled with very soft
soap.
That should do it. Wrap it up and charge it.
Such a pleasure seeing.
Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again, madam.
Did you see that? Looks like business is picking up.
Oh, Ladislaw, I got another letter today.
Oh, from the letter girl? Did she enclose a snapshot this time? Did she say anything about meeting you face to face?
Well, we're going to very soon, but just listen to this. Dear friend, yesterday morning I ran through the rain to the post office. I had the key in my hand, the key to box 1433. Trembling, I opened the door and reached inside, and oh my dear friend, there you were. I took you out, held you in my hand, and looked at you for a moment. And I sat down, gently opened you, and read you.
Mr. Seatbelts, could you spare me one of your stomach pills?
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
Thank you. Mr. Seatbelts, you know whose fault this is?
No, sir.
Yours.
Mine.
Every night that you come to dinner, Mrs. Marichuk tries to fatten you up. She has the cook make cream gravy and dumplings. And what happens? You stay thin and I get heartburn.
Well, I'm very sorry, sir.
George, isn't it about time that you were married? Haven't you had enough of living in furnished rooms, running around to cabarets and dance halls?
Mr. Marichuk, I haven't been to a dance hall in years.
Oh, I know what you bachelor types are like. You have to remember that I was once one myself. And what a bachelor! Young, strong, oh, I was something in days gone by. With some girl who just happened to catch my eye. Slim, straight, light on my feet, shoes just skimming the ground. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, follow at the beat. Around, around, around. All night, circling the floor, till dawn, lit up the sky. No one younger than I, in days gone by. None of my Mrs. Marichuk ever since then I've only danced with her. I bet you think that's incredible.
Well, no, Mrs. Marichuk's a beautiful woman.
Young, strong, oh, I was something in days gone by.
The fact is, I'm a terrible dancer.
With some girl who just happened to catch my eye.
I could move my hands, Mr. Marichuk.
Slim, straight, light on my feet.
I always have trouble with this.
Just skimming the ground. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, follow the beat. Around, around, around. my advice, George. Find yourself one person to dance with. And believe me, it's not necessary to change partners every night.
Oh, Mr. Mayor.
Or even every other night, for that matter. You just think it's necessary. Oh, here they are.
What?
A little surprise for you.
What is it?
A genuine leather box. Here, listen. Here, you try it.
What else does it do?
What do you mean, what else? It's a genuine leather musical cigarette box, and only 10 and 6. How's that for a bargain?
But he's going to buy it.
I can see you're in a difficult mood today, Mr. Novak. Let's ask some other people around here. Get their honest opinions. Mr. Kodai?
Yes, sir?
Will it sell?
Well, I don't see why not, sir. I believe it would make music lovers out of cigarette smokers, and cigarette smokers out of music lovers.
Thank you, Mr. Kodai.
You're welcome, sir.
Now, George, I'll make you a bet. I'll bet you 10 and 6 that we'll sell the first of these boxes within the hour.
I don't want to take your money.
10 and 6. 1 hour. No more, no less. Is it a bet?
Well.
Aha! He's not so confident now.
It's a bet.
You will pay through the notes. You will pay through the notes. Good day, madam. Can I help you?
I'd like a large tube of Mona Lisa.
Mona Lisa cold cream, of course. Isn't that a lovely melody?
Is 7 and 4 the largest size, or is there larger?
No, we also have it in 9 and 6.
I'd like to see that.
This is a genuine leather musical cigarette box.
Do we carry Flowers of Spring in the one-ounce bottle?
Mr. Seepus, your customer.
Yes, sir. Over here, madam.
Good day, madam. Can I help you?
Who do I see about returning this jar of sour face cream?
Mr. Kodai, your customer.
Right this way, please.
Good day, madam. May I help you?
No. Yes.
We have a complete stock of perfumes, soaps, shampoos,
no.
Bath oils, bath salts,
no.
Cold creams, face creams,
no.
Brushes, hard soft, and medium.
No.
We have a special this week only on toilet water, Roses of Italy. I'll show it to you.
Thursday? Good. I'll be by for it.
Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again, madam.
Let me spray a little in your hand.
No!
No?
I'm not going to buy anything. Not today. I'm not going to buy anything. Is Mr. Verichek here?
He's in the back room.
I'd like to speak with him, please.
Perhaps I can help you.
I don't think so.
He's quite busy.
That's all right. I'll just sit here quietly and wait till he's free. I don't mind, really.
May I ask the nature of your business?
I think I'd better talk to him personally.
Very well, then. I'll have your name, please.
Bolish. Amalia Bolish.
Very well, Miss Bolish. I'll tell him you're here.
Oh, one more thing. Miss Horvath, the one that used to work here, she's having a baby. She hasn't been replaced yet, has she?
Are you looking for a job?
No! Well, I guess you could say that. I used to work at Hammerschmidt 5 years. 5 years and 8 months. I have a letter here from Mr. Hammerschmidt himself. It says, Miss Bolish is honest, dependable, dedicated. It's here somewhere. It also says she has an abundance of those qualities which go towards making a superior salesperson. I highly recommend her, signed Herman Hammerschmidt. Oh. Here.
I'm sure it's just as you say, but unfortunately we're not replacing Miss Horvath anytime soon. Now if you'd like to leave your name, please.
Bolish, Amalia Bolish.
And then, if anything should come up...
I would like to speak to Mr. Marichek.
I'm afraid if it's only about a job.
Please.
I'm sorry, it just can't be done.
What can't be done? At Marichek's, nothing is impossible. Perhaps I can help you, madam.
She wants a job.
A what?
I'm a very good salesgirl. I used to work at Hammerschmidt's.
I'm sorry.
I have a letter here from Mr. Hammerschmidt himself.
It's out of the question.
I'm honest, dependable, dedicated.
Really, George, why can't you handle this sort of thing without having to bring me into it?
I'm a very good sales girl, really very good.
If you'll excuse me.
What marvelous boxes and only 10 ansets. Can you imagine?
What are they for?
Oh, candy.
Candy?
Why, yes, madame. Just look at the workmanship. Oh!
A musical candy box?
Why, yes, madame. It combines the three elements of good taste. Attractive to the eye, attractive to the ear, and functional.
How functional?
How? I will tell you. This box has been a lifesaver to many, many women through the years with a slight tendency to overweight. But don't we all? We sit at home reading a good book or listening to a symphony, and without realizing it, our hand slips in the candy box.
We become indiscreet, eating sweet after sweet, though we know all too well where that may lead. So this box was designed with the two of us in mind as the kind of reminder we need. When you raise the lid, the music plays like a disapproving knock, and it sings in your ear no more candy might hear. In a way, it's a little like the voice of God.
I'll take it. Thank you, madame.
Right this way, please. That'll be 3 and 8 for the large jar of face cream.
And 10 and 6 for the box. Thank you, madame. Thank you very much.
You're hired, miss.
Abolish. Amalia, abolish.
Miss Bolish, welcome to Marichex. And now, Mr. Novak, if you please.
14 and 4, 14 and 5, 15.
Your
appointment,
madam.
Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again.
Petty aggravations, and my poor frayed nerves are all askew. I forget these unimportant matters, pouring out my hopes and dreams to you. As I rest my pen and look around me, I can see the summer disappear. Oh dear friend, all at once, autumn's here.
Good morning, Miss Ritter.
Good morning, Arpad.
Look! Autumn!
Yay! Good morning, Alana. Here you are on the first October day, the quintessence of autumn. I hope you have forgiven me about our little misunderstanding last night. I can't bear it when we quarrel. Can you, darling? Truthfully?
Go to hell!
Dear friend, with November just around the corner, I've a feeling you may also share. Do you feel an undertone of discord and a sense of tension in the air?
Mr. Novak, must the sidewalk always be covered in leaves?
Well, no, sir. Mr. Marichek!
If it weren't for your endearing letters, I'd be flying south of the geese. By the way, have you read War and Peace?
Oh, good morning, Miss Polish. I see you're on time today. Congratulations.
I'm sorry to disappoint you.
Oh, I'm not disappointed, Miss Polish. Far from it. Let's just call it surprise.
They're always arguing. Why is that?
A simple chemical reaction. You see, when two people like each other very much...
They like each other?
I think so.
They like each other very much? Don't you think we should tell them?
Parkpat, my boy. They'd never believe us.
Look! Winter!
Have you set your calendar for Tuesday? When we bring this chapter to a close, when I meet my lady of the letters, who puts tiny faces in her own.
In the freezing weather of December, I'll be warmly waiting for it. But until then, count the hours.
I'm late for work, I'm late! Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm not very late, am I? Has Mr. Novak said anything? Where is he?
In the workroom. You're all new with the shoes, the dress, the hair.
I have to tell you, I'm surprised you recognize me. Do I look all right?
Very nice.
Beautiful. It took me 3 hours to get dressed this morning. That's why I'm so late.
I have a feeling our little Miss Balish is in love. And she has a rendezvous with him this evening. How do you know?
Mr. Kodai is an expert on love, which is really quite remarkable, considering he's never been in it.
Good morning, Miss Polish.
He didn't yell at me. What's wrong with him?
He has other things on his mind. Mr. Marichek's very upset.
Again?
And you know who gets the worst of it.
Mr. Novak?
Yes, sir?
You see this?
Why, yes.
You know what it is?
Of course, it's a tube of Mona Lisa cold cream.
Here, let me see you try it.
The back came off.
I was under the impression that it was your responsibility to see that these tubes were correctly filled. If that responsibility is too much, Mr. Novak.
Mr. Marichal.
Or is there something wrong with the tubes? Are they defective?
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Well, then it wouldn't be asking too much for the cream to come out the right end, now would it?
No, it would not be.
Thank you, Mr. Novak. That's all I needed to know.
George! George! Your coat. There's still some Mona Lisa on it.
Oh, thanks, Ladislaw.
You're so nervous, I can feel you vibrating.
It's a new suit. I've never worn it to work before.
What's the occasion?
Oh, the biggest ever. I'm meeting her tonight.
You mean the letter girl? Face to face, at last?
Face to face, at last.
Well, I hope she lives up to your expectations.
Can I tell you something, Ladislaw? I hope she doesn't. I mean, I hope she's not as beautiful as I think she is, or as brilliant as I think she is, because what will she think of me? Just a very ordinary clerk, in a very ordinary shop, and a terrible liar.
A liar?
Oh, the things I wrote in those letters.
You lie.
Well, I certainly exaggerate.
Well, no wonder you're vibrating.
I'm nervous and upset, because this girl I've never met, I get to meet tonight at 8. I'm taking her to dinner to a charming old cafe, but who can eat tonight at 8? It's early in the morning and our date is not till 8 o'clock tonight, and yet already I can see what a nightmare this whole day will be. I haven't slept a wink, I only think of our approaching tete-a-tete tonight at 8. I feel a combination of depression and elation. What a state to wait till 8. 3 more minutes, 2 more seconds, 10 more hours to go. In spite of all I've written, she may not be very smitten, and my hopes perhaps may all collapse. But tonight at 8, I wish I knew exactly how I'll act and what will happen when we dine tonight at 8. I'll know I'll drop the silverware, but will I spill the water or the wine tonight at 8?
Tonight I'll break down beside the smartest girl in town, and then it's anybody's guess. More and more I'm breathing less and less. In my imagination I can hear our conversation taking shape tonight at 8. I'll sit there saying absolutely nothing, or I'll jabber like an ape tonight at 8. 3 more minutes, 2 more seconds, 10 more hours to go. I'll know when this is done, if something's ended or begun, and if it goes alright, who knows, I might propose tonight.
I love Christmas wrapping. It certainly makes a pleasant change. You know, for the past month I've done practically nothing but fill those darn tubes of Mona Lisa. Well, what do you care? You're in love with some nice, eligible young man. Pretty soon you'll be able to kiss all this goodbye. Tell me, what's he like? Tell me all about him. I'd love to suffer. Well, is he tall? So-so. So-so 6 feet? So-so 5 feet? Never measured. Color of hair, color of eyes. Sandy hair, not really light, not really dark. And the eyes? Bluish, greenish.
Brownish?
A little. Is he handsome? Well, I mean, it's difficult to say. At times he is, then again at times he's not.
Well built?
Average.
Would you like a piece of good advice? Don't lose him in a crowd.
Why am I such an unconvincing liar? The truth is, I've never met him. Ever, really.
Never?
That's why I don't know if he's tall, short, wide, narrow, pink, green. I don't even know what his name is.
You mean all this fuss is just over some blind date?
My God, you're even more desperate than I am.
It's not a blind date. I know him.
How?
Letters. Many, many letters.
You belong to the Lonely Hearts Club.
I've never done that sort of thing before. I mean, I used to read the advertisements in the paper.
Well, who hasn't? Young man wants young lady wants young man.
But still, I never paid any attention to them until one day his advertisement showed up. But still, I tried not to answer it. But it kept calling out to me.
He could be 75.
The advertisement said young man.
You haven't even asked for a photograph?
I don't know his name or what he looks like, but I have a much more certain guide. I can tell exactly what he looks like inside. When I undertook this correspondence, little did I know I'd grow so fond. Little did I know I'd I find we're
Tomorrow night, Thursday, Friday?
It's fine. I'm sure we'll get on splendidly without you. That's all, thank you.
That's not all, Mr. Marichek. For the past month, I can't seem to do anything right. What is it? Is it me? Is it you? If my word's bad now, it's been bad for 15 years. Why the hell did you wait till now to start telling me?
How dare you raise your voice in the shop! Clumsy idiot!
Thank you. Please call again, do call again, let up.
You did that on purpose, didn't you?
I had to before you did something foolish like resigning.
I'm not sure I appreciate that.
Oh, I didn't do it for you, George. I did it for me. Who knows? Your successor might walk in, take one look at me and say, what's an oaf like that doing a fancy perfumery like this?
Oh, you're a very good clerk, Ladislaw.
I'm an idiot. But I'm an idiot with a job. Call me fool, that's all right with me. Here's my rule, never disagree. Where's my pride? Swallowed long ago. Deep inside, where it doesn't show. Bowing, scraping, nodding, beaming, always humble, not an ounce of self-respect. Yes, sir, you're so right, sir. Black is white, sir. Excuse me while I genuflect. How do I remain so calm and cheerful? How do I retain my peace of mind? Let me just explain my rationale. It's all in your perspective. Listen. Listen, true and old Hungarian philosophy. I am only one of several in a rather small perfumery, which is only one of several in the city. Which is only one of many in this country, which is only one of many countries which are on this continent, which is only one of seven on this not so special planet, which is only one of many in our solar system, which is only one of many solar systems in this vast and inconceivable affair that is the universe. So, in this infinite, incomprehensible scheme, if a dot called Marichek should scream at a speck called C post, what on earth does it matter? So call me fool, that's all right with me. Here's my rule, never disagree. Where's my pride, swallowed long ago. Deep inside, where it doesn't show. Just maintain a true perspective, and it's easy to avoid a clash of wills. Just maintain a true perspective, and make sure you're well supplied with stomach pills. Let me put it bluntly, I'm a coward, with a wife and children to support.
Actually, my brief is short and simple. Five essential words to it. Do not lose your job.
Miss Ritter.
What?
Here's a charge. I have the lady's name.
Just the name after such a long conversation? No telephone number?
I don't need it. She has mine.
While I have you all here, Miss Balish, Mr. Marichek would like us all to stay late tonight.
Why?
To work on the Christmas decorations, all right?
I guess so.
It's what it is.
Of course.
Hey, ladies.
Mr. Novak? Mr. Novak, I can't stay tonight.
Why not?
I have a date. You know I've got a date.
I know no such thing.
Yes, you do. Why else would I be wearing these new clothes to trim a tree in?
Well, I'm only following Mr. Marichek's instructions.
Well, I can't stay.
You're not being very cooperative, Miss Balish.
Well, why did he have to pick this one day? Or did you pick it, Mr. Novak? Because you knew I had an appointment.
Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again, madam.
I find it very hard to believe anyone can hate me so much.
I do not hate you. But until you came here, this was a happy, peaceful place. Now, the whole atmosphere has changed. Everyone's cranky. Mr. Marichek's on the warpath.
That's not my fault.
The Mona Lisa's coming out the wrong end of the tube.
And that's not my fault. Is it?
You've been filming them.
According to your instruction.
Well, let's not argue about it now. Can we have a truce?
Anytime, Mr. Novak. After all, you're the one always starting things.
Oh, I'm the one.
You've always hated me, since the first day I came here, when I made you lose that bet to Mr. Marichek for 10 and 6, wasn't it? To think that anyone could hate me so much for 10 and 6.
That is nonsense!
Or was it your male pride that was wounded because I went over your head? Men always do seem to resent things like that.
Oh, I do not resent you.
Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, I do not resent you. But if I did, I would have very good reason. Can you deny that you hadn't been here 2 weeks before you started making very public, very humiliating remarks about me?
Only because you went around calling me Miss Amalia Balish. Miss Amalia Balish! You think I liked that?
You think I liked you criticizing my socks, my tie, my fingernails?
Much better.
That must be the rudest, most difficult, worst temper girl in the world.
Hey, madam, may I help you?
Yes, I'd like to see the lily scented soap.
Well, Mr. Novak, hard at work as usual, I see.
Good day, ladies. May I help you?
Have you made the arrangements about tonight?
Yes, Miss Ritter, Mr. Kodai, and Mr. Seacoast can stay. Our pad, of course.
What about Miss Balish?
I'm afraid she has an appointment.
An appointment. Well, I guess you couldn't prevail upon her to stay when you're not going to.
Any other night, Mr. Marichek.
There seem to be a great many things, Mr. Novak, that interest you far more than your position here.
Mr. Marichek, I am devoted to this shop. I couldn't work harder if I owned it.
If you owned it, well, let me tell you something, my young friend. You will never get your hands in this shop. Never. Not if I have to come down from heaven and stop you myself. Is that clear?
Yes, it's perfectly clear.
Now get away from me! Just get away from me!
I will get away, and permanently!
Can I take that as your resignation, Mr. Novak?
That's exactly what it is.
Very well then, I accept! Effective immediately! Miss Ritter will have your final pay!
Is this the large or the medium?
The large?
Well then, can I have the medium? And can you make it quick? I haven't got an egg.
I would like a case of Castile soap and a powder puff shampoo. Is there a sale on? Let me have a hairnet bubble bath. How much do you charge for your model Lisa? Can you recommend an unusual perfume? Something rather chic but inexpensive that would make a novel Christmas gift, I think.
Well, it should come as good news to you, Miss Balish. Very good news. I've just quit my job.
Why?
Well, the fact is, I didn't have much of a choice.
I don't know what to say.
Well, then don't say anything, especially not if you're sorry. Let's not end our relationship on that note. Goodbye, Miss Barber.
Mr. Novak, does the condemned cannot have one final word? I never mentioned any more, ever. You must know that.
Oh, I believe you, Miss Barber. May I say, I hope to meet a very nice man and have many children. For the sake of my successor in this job, I hope it's soon.
That there's more to me than I may always show.
Vladislav, have you got a pack of icicles over there?
Icicles? I don't see any.
Would you ask Mr. Kodai if he's got them?
Miss Ritter would like to know if you've got her icicles.
Icicles? Tell her that's all I've been getting from her for several weeks now.
He says...
I heard him. Why else would I be laughing so uncontrollably?
Sipos, look at me when I talk to you. What do you think of a woman that goes with a man, tells him she loves him, and then suddenly drops him?
Before you answer that, Vladislav, what do you think of a man who breaks 3 dates with a girl in a little over a week?
A little over a week?
8 dates!
I don't recall 3 dates!
You don't recall anything! You never did!
Oh, but that's where you're wrong, Ilona. I recall our evenings together. I recall them very well, in fact. Private little booth, the Rathskeller. Remember? Oh, come on, Ilona, let's go there tonight. You always love the Rathskeller. Chinese food. It's a fortune teller. Ilona?
Mr. Marichak says we can go.
You're all ready. I'll just be a minute. Arpad, will you grab me my things?
Ilona, this is going to be a bit difficult to explain, but I won't be able to take you to the Rathskeller after all.
What?
Well, you see, I thought we'd be working late tonight, so I canceled a previous appointment. But now that we're leaving early, I've just got to keep it. You do understand, don't you, darling? Oh, trust me, sweetheart, we'll go to the Rathskeller another night. Let's see now, tonight is Tuesday. What about next Monday? Alona? Cherie?
I resolve not to be so stupid.
Really?
I resolve not to play these games. How often I've been a city dumper cupid.
Is that all right, sweetheart?
How often I've let him shoot me down in flames.
Sweetheart, say it's all right.
I resolve not to be so trusting. It's high time, time that I go home. Whatever I've got up here, it's up here busting. My feminine intuition is a joke. I'm a sweet cousin to a cat. I always wind up with a rat. I'm through with momentary thrills. I find I can't afford the bed.
She'll be sitting there, alone, and on the table in front of her, there'll be a copy of Anna Karenina, with a rose in it.
Your lady friend, the one with the little letters.
And I'll have the same rose here.
That's a romantic picture. Very romantic. There's just one thing.
One thing?
What am I doing there?
Oh, well, you're gonna give her this rose, this letter, which tells her that I've been caught out of town on urgent business, so I'll write to her as soon as possible.
Won't she be disappointed?
She'd be more disappointed if you saw me the way I am tonight. Just give the letter for me, please, Ladislav, and thank her. I really appreciate this.
Although,
please, let's go. For all I know, she got tired of waiting and went home long ago.
Mr. Keller?
Mr. Marichek?
Come in, please.
Can we speak here?
Everyone's gone.
As I told you on the phone, sir, we've completed our investigation.
Who sent this to me?
I'm afraid we don't know that, sir. Anonymous letters can be difficult to track down, but we have checked its contents. As you'll see, we've been following Mrs. Marichek, and there's no doubt. She's involved one of your clerks, just as the letter said.
There's no doubt?
I'm sorry, sir.
I've known all along. I just had to be sure.
She's been going to his apartment, number 17 Court Street. Each visit is listed. Would you like to have us do an investigation of Mr. Kodai?
Who?
Mr. Kodai. Stephen Kodai. That's his name.
But I thought...
Number 17 Court Street. Stephen Kodai, second floor, apartment 6.
Kodai? It's just that he's never met Mrs. Marichek. And there's another clerk here, a clerk who's been to our house several times, and I just thought, I naturally thought-
Can you read the report, sir?
Yes, thank you.
Will that be all? Then I'll be saying goodnight.
Goodnight, Mr. Keller.
Hello, Marichek here. Oh, hello, love. Yes, I know. You'll be out late then? I see. Well, give her my best. No, I just feel a bit tired, that's all. Of course. No, I won't wait up. So do I. Goodbye.
As your own,
Bear in mind the gravity of your task. For these lovers' hearts is one shining hour. Is that such a terrible lot to ask? Look around and see for yourself the romantic atmosphere.
Victor!
Stephanie! That's what all our patrons demand. That's the reason why they're here.
Victor! Hugo!
Anyone coming here just for the moon? And if you don't believe me, try tasting our food. That's why we have got to preserve a romantic atmosphere. Well then go talk to her and find out.
She's not dear friend. She's not dear. She can't be. Can she? Miss Polish!
Mr.
Mr. Novak, what are you doing here?
Celebrating. How about you?
I'm waiting for someone.
Anyone in particular?
Well, of course. What kind of girl do you... Never mind, I know.
Mind if I sit down for a moment?
Yes, I do. You may not.
You won't help me celebrate?
Celebrate?
My freedom is polished. Just think of it. Tomorrow's Wednesday and I get to sleep in as late as I like.
Mr. Novak, I told you that chair happens to be reserved.
You'll have one drink with me?
I can't.
One small farewell drink?
If it's very small and very quick.
Thank you, Miss Ball. Well, here's to Marichek's, and all the people who work there, and all the people who used to work there, and the customers.
And that covers everything.
Good wine.
Mr. Novak, are you spying on me?
Spying?
Did you come here to make sure I really had a date, that I wasn't just making up an excuse not to come to work today?
Who would I be spying for? Marichek?
Mr. Novak, leave this instant or I will have to call the waiter.
Yes, madam.
Oh, there you are.
Yes, may I put a word in? Just one word. The Café Imperial is a rendezvous for young lovers. Look around you. We try to preserve a romantic atmosphere. But I find it very difficult to do so when you and your husband insist on fighting right in the middle of it. Can't you argue at home?
This is not my husband. This is a business associate.
Well, talk business someplace else.
You say you're meeting someone here. Someone you've known for very long.
Mr. Novak, will you leave?
You know, it's not right for a man to keep a girl waiting so long in such a public place as this.
Mr. Novak, will you please leave?
Even if he's an old friend? A dear friend?
I do not wish to discuss this with you.
What's the name of that tune? I remember my mother used to sing it for me when I was a baby.
So did I.
Miss Polish, do you realize we've just found something in common? At one point in time, we were both infants.
But I grew up.
I think it's called Tango Tragique.
What if he's already been here and seen us together and left? I'll never forgive you, Mr. Novak, never!
What's this?
Put that back.
Anna Karenina.
Yes, it's a book by Leo Tolstoy of Russia. Now, will you please put it back?
What's this for?
That is none of your business.
Miss Polish, is it possible you've never even met this man?
That's ridiculous.
Oh, of course it is. And yet, you know, some men, some women, do make appointments with strangers, and sometimes it turns out rather well, and sometimes it turns out not so well. I remember a girl I used to know. She belonged to a Lonely Hearts Club, and she started corresponding with a man, and they decided to meet. And I seem to recall that she was to have a rose in her book, and he was to have the same rose in his buttonhole. And I guess they did meet. For the very next day, the police found her left leg floating in the Danube. And you know, they never did find the rest of her or her book.
At the count of five, I'll scream the song. You'd better go and soon. What?
Please, I just want to talk to you.
Don't forget I've had some wine and nothing to eat since noon.
Miss Polish, are you intoxicated?
Dante once described all the depths of hell. If I have my way, you will know them well.
Miss Polish.
Three, you are easily the most insensitive man alive.
You surprised me.
I'm sorry, but I'm fighting for my life. Four and a half, will you go? Then a five.
Trying to ruin me, lady, I warned you. Get out! That's all! Get out! You too! Get out! Screaming like lunatics, that's all! Get out!
How dare you speak to a lady that way?
Ladies don't scream in cafes!
Oh, I'm afraid you don't quite understand, you see. There was a fly in the wine.
What?
I said, a fly in the wine.
Where is it? Show it to me.
Well, I'm afraid that's quite impossible, you see. The lady is swallowed.
She swallowed?
Wouldn't you scream?
Good God!
I do not understand you.
How could you? You never listened to me. You never even looked at me.
How wrong you are, Mr. Novak. I'm looking at you now. Shall I tell you what I see? I see a petty, pompous tyrant, very sure of himself and very ambitious. And I see him 10 years from now selling shampoo. And 20 years from now selling shampoo. And 30 years from now still selling shampoo, because basically, you know what he is. A not very bright, not very young, not very handsome man with balding hair and the personality of a python! Mr. Novak! Mr. Novak! I didn't mean all of those things!
Don't call him. He'll come back. We're closing up soon.
So soon? But I'm still waiting for someone. He'll have a rose in his lapel.
To match the one in your book. Oh, how late is he?
Over 2 hours.
You're a very patient young lady.
I've been waiting for him all my life. What's 2 hours?
Yes, this one is on the house. For luck.
Thank you. You know, this is a very nice cafe.
Thank you. We try to preserve a romantic atmosphere.
Without writing or explaining? Does that ever happen?
Sometimes. Sometimes she looks at him and she goes away.
How heartbreaking that must be.
Yes, but you don't have no need to worry. You're a nice, presentable girl. Well, not a beauty contest winner, but you should see some of the others.
I make believe nothing is wrong. How long can I pretend? Please make it right. Don't break my heart. Don't let it end
I have never spoken. And why break someone in when I'm already broken? In this emergency, I wouldn't let you down. Mr. Marajack, come try me. And I can see by the uncertain play of ground that you ask yourself, why me? For first class clerking and conscientious working, Mr. Marajack, why not try me?
Alright, screw sour. Very sour. Take it back.
You wish to return this jar, madam. Certainly right you are, madam. You say it smells like a drowning cat. It does at that. Marajack smiling, playing with pride. The customer must be satisfied. The customer must be satisfied. By the way, we have a special sale on autumn heather. Let me spray some on your hand. Here, we'll smell it together. It has the three elements of good perfume: attractive to the nose, invisible to the eye, and functional. My wife has used it time and again. It's very appealing to us men. I use it myself every now and then.
I'll take it!
Certainly, madam!
Oh, Miss Ritter!
Miss Ritter?
That's 26 for the autumn heather, 8 and 3 for the cream, 32 even for that bottle of mermaid tree, 1 and 3 for the eyebrow pencil, 9 for the large shampoo, and then for the jar you're bringing back, that's 4 and 2 for you. That's a total of 98 less 4 and 2 for the jar. Out of 100, cha-ching, here's your change, 5 and 2, there you are, the biggest sale in several years, I believe. Thank you, madam, please call again, glad I could help, here is my card. Thank you, madam, please call again, call again. I would gladly grow a mustache if you'd like, Mr. Marajack, try me. I would even think of giving up my fight, Mr. Marajack, try me. For first class clerking and conscientious working, Mr. Marajack, why not try me?
Very impressive.
Excuse me, Madison, shortchange me.
Mr. Marajack.
Oh, George.
What happened?
He shot himself accidentally. He was cleaning his gun.
Arcade, will you please leave us alone?
Are you in very much pain, Mr. Marajack?
Oh, the only place that it doesn't hurt is my left shoulder, where I shot myself.
Is there anything I can do to help you?
First, there's something that I must do, something very important. If I could stand up, I'd walk over to you, take you by the hand, and beg you to forgive me, Mr. Novak.
Oh, I forgive you, Mr. Marajack. Whatever happened, whatever it happened, I don't care.
No, you can't let me off that easily. There's a horrible thing that I did to you, and there's no excuse. Well, I guess there is one excuse. The jealousy of an old man.
Jealousy?
Oh, poor George. Still in the dark. I guess you're the only man in the world who's ever had an affair without knowing it.
An affair?
You've been having an affair with my wife.
With your wife? With Mrs. Marichek?
I have all the facts.
It's not true.
Oh, I know it's not true. I know now. But last week, and 2 weeks ago, I didn't know.
I can't believe it. Did you really think?
That's just the point. I didn't think.
I can't get over it.
Well, George, starting today, if you're willing, I'd like you to take over the shop.
Well, of course. At least keep the doors open until you're well enough to come back.
Here are the keys. Oh, and George, now that you're the boss, if you'd like to give yourself a raise...
Well, I'll have a little talk with myself, and if I don't ask for too much, I may grant it.
The perfect executor! Now, you better get going. You're going to be very short-handed at the shop today. Miss Bolish isn't coming in.
Miss Bolish? Why not?
She's sick.
What's wrong with her?
She didn't say, but you're going to be without one other clerk as well. Mr. Kodai, I want you to fire him.
Fire him?
Just give him 2 weeks' salary.
I didn't realize Mr. Kodai was that unsatisfactory. He worked so hard.
But did all the wrong things.
I'm not sure I understand.
Maybe one day if you see Mrs. Marichek, she'll explain it to you. Well, George, I guess I'm a bachelor again, same as you. Perhaps one night you could take me to a cabaret.
Oh, I
know. You don't go to cabarets.
Well, I'll stop by later and give you a full report.
I'll be here, my boy. Thank you.
Well, have you been thinking about me as a sales clerk?
Quite seriously. But there's just one thing. You're so attached to your bicycle. How could you ever bear to part with it?
What if I didn't part with it? Altogether, I could be part delivery boy, part sales clerk.
Arpad, you just made your first sale.
I did?
As of right now, and I guess we can't call you Arpad anymore. What's your last name? Do you have a last name?
Laszlo.
Mr. Laszlo. Welcome to... Marichek's.
Mr. Laszlo. Mr. Laszlo.
Now you better get going, my boy.
You can count on me. And thank you, Mr. Marichek. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Arpad.
All night, circling the floor, till dawn lit up the sky. No one younger.
Just tell me if it's cold out. Oh, I'll need a splash.
yourself.
What is it?
Vanilla ice cream. It's the best thing in the world when you're sick.
It's from Lindner's. My mother works at Lindner's. She may have waited on you.
Was she a small, stout woman?
Oh no. The very image of me, everyone says, only much younger looking. There's something wrong with this ice cream.
There is?
So much salt.
Well, no wonder, all those tears falling into it.
Oh, I better cry in the other direction.
Why cry at all?
How little you understand, Mr. Novak. I'm like a rag doll and all the stuffing's been kicked out.
Well, you soon fill up again, good as new.
You're looking at a very disillusioned girl, Mr. Novak.
You know, I'll never forgive myself for last night at the cafe. I must have been drunk.
Yet, strangely enough, you were right. And I didn't know the man I was waiting for. He had just been writing to me. Such glorious letters.
And he never showed up.
I waited till closing.
I feel very responsible.
Oh no, it wasn't just you. I'm sure there's any number of reasons why he didn't come. But if he cared at all, he would have written a note, two words, something.
Miss Polish, he will write.
I don't think so.
Oh, I'm not just guessing. I know it definitely.
How?
Well, he told me himself.
He? Himself?
Well, why, yes, dear friend, no one else.
Dear friend? When, Mr. Novak? Tell me!
Let's see now. Last night, as I was leaving the cafe, I had the strange feeling that somebody was following me, and I kept looking. Oh. There was a
young man?
A man who, when I got close to him, started asking questions about you and me.
What sort of questions?
Oh, you know, just what you'd expect.
I want to know the words he used.
Well, I'm not very good at remembering the exact words.
Try, please.
Well, let's see now. I think the first thing he said was, "Excuse me, but I'd like to ask you a question," or something like that. And then he said, "Did you just leave the Cafe Imperial? You want to know what I said, too?"
Of course.
All right. I said yes.
And then?
And then he said, "Tell me, that girl you're sitting with, was she a special friend of yours?" Special friend, those were his exact words. And I said, "No." We just worked at the same shop. As a matter of fact, she has an appointment with somebody else tonight. Oh, I remember him very clearly now, and I remember that he suddenly looked quite sad.
He looked sad?
Quite sad. And he said, "I know she has an appointment tonight. It's with me. I have to take the next train out of town on urgent business."
Urgent business? Do you think he's a shop owner or a manufacturer?
Well, he certainly looked well fed.
Well fed?
Well, to judge by appearances, of course. That's not so uncommon in a man of his age. You have some wonderful books here, Miss Polish. The Red and the Black. I've been so anxious to read this. I wonder, would you lend it to me sometime?
What did you mean, a man of his age?
Pardon me?
You said it's not uncommon in a man of his age. How old is he?
Well, you see, it was a dark night and he had an exhausting day. Emotionally, at any rate. I'd put his age at, you know, it's very hard to tell. Maybe possibly if he had some hair? Have you read The Magic Mountain?
What?
The Magic Mountain. I bought it for myself, for my birthday. I lend it to you if you'd like.
Is he completely bald?
Well, does that matter? I thought you said you were in love with him.
I am, Mr. Novak, I am. It's just, I thought, I had hoped. I'm so ashamed of myself. As if appearances make a difference. The thing that matters are the letters. I just look at all the immortal works of art, and by old men, bald men, fat men, with indigestion and terrible tempers. But somewhere deep inside, they had a magic that is beyond description.
You put it very well, Miss Polish.
I feel very well. I feel fantastic. Thank you, Mr. Novak. Thank you. Thank you for my life. I'm going to write to him so he has a letter waiting.
But I won't mention you, because that might be interesting.
I would appreciate that. Well, I better get going, Miss Balash.
And I'll follow as soon as I've written a letter.
Oh, no need for that. Just stay home. Take the rest of the day off. Relax. Read a book. Did you finish Anacrinidia yet?
Oh, yes. A long time ago.
So did I, but it's remarkable how it stays with me. You know, every platform, every station platform with the train pumping in, Xana's platform, wherever it may be. And I can see her, actually see her, walk slowly out of the crowd towards her death. And I've even tried to stop her a few times, but she always vanishes into the smoke and steam.
How odd, Mr. Novak, how very odd. You know, I wish I could show it to you. In one of his letters...
You mean dear friends have the same experience?
More than once.
Well, I'll be going.
Oh, Mr. Novak, may I tell you something quite sincerely? I like you, Mr. Novak. Really, I like you.
Thank you, Miss Polish. I'll see you in the morning.
In the morning. Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together you and I will laugh at last night's summer day. Ice cream, he brought me ice cream.
I didn't like her. I couldn't stand her.
I couldn't stand her, I wouldn't have her. I never knew her, but now I do. And I could, and I would, and I know. She loves me, and to my amazement, I love it, knowing that she loves me. She loves me, true she doesn't show it. How could she, when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loved me, bah, now today she likes me, bah, and tomorrow, tomorrow, ah, my teeth ache from the urge to touch her. I'm speechless, for I mustn't tell her. It's wrong now, but it won't be long now before my love discovers that she and I are lovers. Imagine how surprised she's bound to be. She loves me. She loves me. I love her. Isn't that a wonder? I wonder why I didn't want her. I wonder, this thing that matters, and matters are improving daily. Yesterday I loathed her, now today I like her, and tomorrow, tomorrow, ah, tingles, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling, what the hell does that mean? I'm freezing, that's because it's cold out. And still I'm incandescent, and like some adolescent, I'd like to scrawl on every wall I see. She loves me. She loves me.
Too young, too skinny.
I think he's beautiful. Welcome back, George.
Congratulations, George.
Excuse me, but I could use some help in the shop. They're still our customers, you know.
That reminds me. I need to have a word with Mr. Godaldo.
Isn't it wonderful?
A miracle. An absolute miracle. A word with Mr. Godaldo?
Oh, forget about him. That's all in the past.
It is?
Ever since last night, remember what a silly, confused girl I was last night?
You were.
Oh, very. I didn't know what to do or where to go, and somehow my feet started walking down the street, across the bridge, past the Metropole Cinema, and do you know where?
Where?
Right into the library.
The library?
Can you imagine?
So did you like it?
Ugh, you've never seen such a place. So many books. And so much marble and so quiet. And suddenly all of my confidence dribbled away with a pitiful plop. My head was beginning to swim and my forehead was covered with cold perspiration. I started to reach for a book and my head automatically came to a stop. I don't know how long it's been frozen, a victim of panic and mortification. Oh, kindly voice, a gentle voice, whispered, pardon me.
Pardon me?
And there was this dear, sweet, clearly bespectacled, thickly bespectacled man who stood by my side and quietly said to me, ma'am, don't mean to intrude, but I was just wondering, are you in need of some help? I said no. Yes, I am. The next thing I know, I'm sipping hot chocolate and telling my troubles to those tender brown eyes kept sending compassionate looks. A trip to the library. to have been in the back of my mind. I was praying he wouldn't get fresh. And all the while I was wondering why an illiterate girl should attract him. Then all of a sudden he said that he couldn't go wrong with the way of all flesh. Of course it's a novel, but I didn't know, or I certainly wouldn't have smacked him. Well, he gave me a smile that I couldn't resist. And I knew at once how much I liked this optometrist. You know what this dear, sweet, slightly bespectacled gentleman said to me next? He said he would solve this problem of mine. I said, how? He said, if I'd like, he'd willingly read to me some of his favorite things. I said, when? He said now. His novel approach seemed highly suspicious and possibly dangerous too. I told myself, wait, think, dare you go up to his foot? What happens if things go wrong? It's obvious he's quite strong. He read to me all night long. Now how about that? It's hard to believe how truly domestic and happily hopeful I feel. I picture my Paul there reading aloud as I could. As long as he's there to read, there's quite a good chance indeed. A chance that I'll never need to open a book. Unlike someone else, someone I dimly recall, I know he'll only have eyes for me, my optometrist Paul.
Well, I might as well tell you, Mr. Quidai is leaving us right now, Mr. Marichek's orders.
Why? I mean, it's nice, but what happened?
I'm afraid I can't tell you.
I bet I know. I told him they'd catch up with him. Do you know that half this shop's perfume and toilet water ended up in his apartment? I mean, he told me.
Well, now that you're back and everything's sorted itself out, I might as well tell you. I sent the anonymous letter.
Wait. What anonymous letter?
You didn't know? What do you think caused all this fuss? I wrote to Mr. Marichek saying his wife was involved with one of his clerks.
I don't believe you.
I was desperate. Business was so bad. And I thought to myself, if he fires Mr. Quidai, who deserves it, he might not fire me, who doesn't.
Do you understand how much trouble you've caused?
And I regret it to the day I die. But who would have guessed Mr. Marichek thought it was you I was talking about?
Well, I certainly hope you've learned your lesson.
Oh, absolutely I have. In the next letter, name the names.
I'll have 2 weeks' pay for Mr. Quidai, please.
Here it is. No, my pleasure. Good day, madam. May I help you?
Do you carry flowers of spring?
Mr. Seepos, guess what?
What?
I'm a clerk.
Well, congratulations, Arpad.
Mr. Marichek just promoted me. Oh, and another thing. I'm not Arpad anymore.
Really? Then who are you?
Mr. Laszlo.
Thank you, madam. Please call again, do call again, madam.
Miss Reuter, I'd like you to meet our newest clerk, Mr. Laszlo.
It's true. Ask Mr. Marichek.
Arpad, how wonderful.
What's wonderful?
I'm a clerk, starting right now. A clerk!
Can you believe it? Stephen Quidai replaced by a delivery boy.
Replaced?
Yes, Arpad, I just resigned. I'm leaving. I wouldn't stay here another day.
You couldn't. You've been fired.
Believe that if it makes you happy. But you won't be happy for very long, because any day now, those doors are closed for the last time. Then you just have to take a walk over to Hammersmith's.
Why? It's closed.
Only temporarily, due to renovations. Because, you see, there's going to be a new owner. Stephen Kodai!
Some owner.
Nevertheless, it's true. Alona believes me, don't you, darling?
Of course I do. Here's your down payment.
Oh, Cherie. It's been grand knowing you, grand knowing you, grand being your friend. You've been kind, loyal, and so generous, right down to the end. Please don't grieve watching me leave. That would be much too painful to stand. It's been fun, now I must run, but it's been grand, perfectly grand. Ilona, farewell, Cherie, be brave. Jim, it's been sublime. You mustn't waste a precious moment, me. You don't have time. Just remember when you're lonely or blue, there's a hollow in my pillow for you. And Sipos, my friend, what can I say? Ah, Sipos. No tears, be gay, you know. Old friend, I'm in your debt. I owe you more than I can possibly repay. I won't forget. Give your wife a little kiss from goodnight. I never met her. I will.
By and by.
Though I hate leaving your warm, intimate club. It's a small pleasure, but I'll treasure each warm, intimate snub. It's been grand, let me say, and let me say au revoir, not goodbye. For it's grand knowing you'll all be working for your friend. Go down.
Mr. Novak.
Well, drummer, 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 drummer
Mr. Merichek, Christmas Eve, the shop, all of us. Merry Christmas!
Matt?
Thank you. George?
Yes, sir?
Let's say you and I go to a gala dinner. We could go to some nice, fancy restaurant. Faber's, perhaps.
I wish I could, but...
But you weren't expecting me, I understand.
It's just that I've been invited by Miss Polish.
Don't give it a second thought, my boy. It's not that important.
I think it looks like it is!
He's here! Mr. Ritter's friend!
Isn't he handsome?
Intelligent looking.
He has beautiful eyes.
He's an optometrist.
Much better than Mr. Could I, I'll say that.
I love the way he walks.
And that coat, that hat.
Is he rich?
I don't know.
He's got dimples. Well, that settles it. Tonight, when he asks me to marry him, I'll say yes. Alone, I had no idea.
Neither does he.
Well, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Good evening.
Ah, you. Well, I'd better be heading home. The wife and children are waiting, and my wife's sister, and her children, and God knows who else. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Arpad?
Yes, sir?
Are you busy tonight?
No, sir.
Oh, yes, you are. You and I are going to Faber's.
Faber's? What is it?
George, Arpad and I are going out for a night on the town.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Merry Christmas, Miss Polish. George.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Novak.
Merry Christmas.
I'm going to Faber's.
So tell me, Mr. Laszlo, is there anything special that you'd like for Christmas?
It's too much to hope for.
Well, what is it?
But I won't get it anyway.
You have to at least tell me.
Well, what I really want most, more than anything, is a motorcycle.
You're right, my boy. You won't get it.
Let me help you with those. The cigarette box.
I know you hate them, but I rather like them, I thought, as a gift for dear friend.
But what if he's not a smoker?
He likes music.
And it is just the box. You know, Miss Polish, I don't hate these things nearly as much as I used to. In fact, I wouldn't mind owning one myself.
You wouldn't?
Only to remind me of the first day you came here. Do you remember? I'll never forget it. Oh, what kind of box, madam? Oh, it's a candy box, and it's functional.
I was terrified, and you were so awful. Did I really sound like that?
You sounded irresistible. As a matter of fact, I remember thinking, that's the kind of girl I could fall in love with.
But you were so awful.
I know.
And you never said anything.
How could I? I knew the way you felt about me.
But you didn't, really, you didn't. Because I was attracted to you. More than attracted.
Awful as I was?
It's a shame you never spoke up.
And you?
Who knows what might have been.
I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I will laugh at last night someday.
I had to tell you, I couldn't stand it until you knew.
Oh, George, I was so anxious. I was so tempted. I wouldn't dare.